1880, two things happened extremely detrimental to our republic. Whereas income inequality rewards hard work, talent, and achievement, a heavy dose of wealth inequality encourages greed and social isolation.
The recent past has seen greater economic inequality in America than at any time since the Great Depression. In the three decades after World War II, American incomes grew quickly and equally. But starting in the late 1970s, things began to change.
The top 1% hold closer to 40% of the national wealth. So for every dollar in American assets, that's home, stock, savings, all that, 40 cents of it belongs to the top 1%. The top 1% holds more wealth in America than the bottom 90% of the country combined. And a lot of that money gets passed on to their children or their children's children. This is a doom loop of oligarchy. Wealth buys power, power buys more wealth means more power means more wealth, and on we go until a very small fraction of the population has a whole lot of the power and a whole lot of the money.
Right now, it's perfectly legal to buy political influence in America. Here's how it works. Let's say a big bank wants a law that would force taxpayers to bail them out again if they repeat the exact same reckless behavior that crashed the global economy in 2008. Not exactly the most popular idea with the public, and Congress knows that. That should be the end of it. But that's where the money comes in. It's perfectly legal for our bank to hire a team of lobbyists whose entire job is to make sure that the government gives the bank what it wants. Then, those lobbyists can track down members of Congress who regulate banks and help raise a ton of money for their re-election campaigns. It's perfectly legal for those lobbyists to offer those same politicians million-dollar jobs at their lobbying firm. Then, those lobbyists can literally write the language of this new bailout law themselves and hand it off to the politician they just buttered up with campaign money and lucrative job offers. And it's perfectly legal for those politicians to take the lobbyist-written language and sneak it through Congress at the last second. So now you've got a law that greatly benefits the banks, and the whole process can start over. This is how a bill becomes a law. A special interest hires some lobbyists, those lobbyists collect campaign contributions, offer jobs, and then write the laws that Congress then passes to help those same special interests. This happens every day on every single issue with politicians of both parties. In the last 5 years alone, the 200 most politically active companies in the United States spent $5.8 billion influencing your government. Those same companies got $4.4 trillion in taxpayer support. And that's trillion, with a T. And that's just the top 200 companies. Never mind every other special interest, every union, every trade association, and every billionaire. Every single one of them can use their money to buy political influence. You know, there's this idea out there that this only became a problem after the Supreme Court's Citizens United decision in 2010. But the data goes back almost 40 years, and the results are clear. Corruption is legal in America. And as long as it is, anyone who can spend money to buy political influence will.